Wake County. A manhunt is underway for the person who shot and killed a Wake County deputy. It happened along Battle Bridge Road earlier this morning. And WRAL's Keenan Willard is tracking the sheriff's response to this tragedy and how it all unfolded.
Well, 8 hours into this investigation, there is still an all-hands-on-deck effort to find out the answers that I think everyone is looking for at this point. How did this happen, and who's responsible? You can see the heavy law enforcement presence stretching down Battle Bridge that's still present here, even though it's been, as I said, more than 8 hours since this incident took place overnight. And the only information we have confirmed at this point is that a Wake County Sheriff's deputy was killed in this shooting. We still have not had a suspect identified. There has been no explanation from the sheriff's office of how exactly this shooting played out, what led up to this incident, only that a sheriff's deputy has died. So at this point, they've been taking aerial photos with drones, trying to take a look from above at this setup. They've also been trying to look at security cameras from a nearby gas station where we've actually been setting up for the last few hours throughout the morning. And at this point, there's been this ongoing effort to communicate to the community just how grief-stricken the sheriff's office is after this has happened. The sheriff, Gerald Baker, addressed us with tears in his eyes. He is so moved and devastated by the loss of one of his deputies. You can take a look at his message that he sent to us early this morning.
Breaks my heart to have to report that a member of this office.
Right now, we are still waiting at this point for the deputy to be identified. That information is expected to come out in the coming hours. We're also expecting to see if a suspect will be identified, and any motive or explanation for the shooting will come out as well. All of that information still undecided and unspoken at this point, but they are working hard to get that to us. Keenan Willard, the WRAL Morning News.